Arvind, the lone party, represented on the Newshour tonight by a representative of the Arvind, the lone party, is Professor Kamal Mitra Chinoy. Ragini Nayak of the Congress party is taking on the Arvind, the lone party. Nalin Kohli of the BJP as well, is also an advocate. He's also taking on the Arvind, the lone party, ex-member of the Arvind, the lone party, and now with the BJP. Shazia Ilmi is joining the debate, and also to discuss the Arvind, the lone party tonight is Aarti Jairath and Ajay Bose, senior journalist. Kamal Mitra Chinoy, how embarrassing for you. I almost sympathize with you. You used to be an outspoken man. Now there are various issues you can't talk about. You can't talk about the lack of transparency in the functioning of your party bodies. You can't talk about inner party democracy. You can't talk about the party becoming a one-man party. If criminals are put up in elections, you can't talk about it. If a political compromise is made and you tie up with the Congress, maybe in the future you'll tie up with the BJP, you won't be able to talk about it. Why are you still a member of this Arvind Alone party? What do you hope to change being a member of a party ridden by intrigue and power lust like this?
Arnab.
Yes.
Arnab, have you finished?
Yes, please.
I would refer you to my post of the 2nd March on my public Facebook.
Yes.
Where I referred to the problems of the AAP on 2nd March.
So are you quitting?
And it was titled A Plea for Reason.
Are you quitting?
And I if I have a problem, I will go to the Lokpal. I will do nothing without exhausting all the avenues
which
at my
Lokpal?
Command.
The Arvind Alone Party is internal Lokpal.
On my values.
Pardon me? The internal Lokpal,
yes,
of the Arvind Alone Party.
Yes, it's an internal Lokpal, but it is because of the internal Lokpal that 6 women are going to be in the cabinet by rotation.
Okay, first counter is coming in from Ragini, please. Ragini is coming in, please.
May I say? I warned against this. I warned against a problem in the organization. I said people should not leak and speak.
What do you mean leak and speak?
And that the people were looking to us for support and for going forward with the program. And I warned that we should be careful. Because it was clear.
What do you mean warned? What do you mean warned? Basically, what do you mean warned? Basically, are you one of Arvind Kejriwal's henchmen that you are warning people not to speak? I thought you're one of the most sort of thinking people.
Are you a henchman
of Arvind
not
Kejriwal?
Not speak. You are distorting it, Arnab. Leak and speak was the problem.
What do you mean leak and speak?
If you speak openly, no problem. But if you leak, you see the newspapers about AAP in the last week.
What a sad situation on your party today. How sad.
Have the courage to say.
Look at the situation. Look at the situation of the Aam Aadmi Party. It stings journalists. People, it stings journalists. Ask journalists who was your source about the problems inside the party, and it's found out the source is Yogendra Yadav. Come, let's get together, throw him out. 2 counters coming tonight. By the way, most people are saying today there are only 2 people who compete with each other in terms of absolute hold over the party. One is the Arvind Alone Party, AAP, and the other is the RAP, which is the Rahul Alone Party. Shazia and Ragini want to respond. Ragini, please, representing the Rahul Alone Party tonight. Yes, please, Ragini.
Please do not compare apples with oranges, Arnab. I'll begin by saying that. And I don't know what kind of a lame excuse is Mr. Chinoy.
Oh, they are apple and orange, all
although
right.
Although the Congress party refrains itself. Please, let me complete. Today we are talking about the rift within the Aam Aadmi Party, and let's stick to the topic. You see, although the Congress party refrains from taking sadistic pleasure in the internal controversies, internal rifts leading to ignominy of another political party, but there are certain observations which have to be put in the public domain for the people to decide. There is something rotten in the state of Denmark, wrote Shakespeare in Hamlet, to highlight a situation where something is terribly wrong, rife with errors from top to bottom in a political hierarchy. And taking a cue from there, I insist that despite the resignation drama of Mr. Kejriwal and despite the failed attempt towards striking a compromise deal, there is something rotten within the folds of the Aam Aadmi Party that every now and then we hear voices of dissent related to questions on the foundational ideals of the party, namely lack of internal democracy, lack of transparency in decision making, lack of attempt towards consensus building, and this party going the way of becoming a one-man centric party run by Mr. Kejriwal in his trademark my way or the highway style of politics. But what is even more depressing is that certain voices, all these voices of dissent, are crushed. Inquisitive voices within the party are stifled, and some people are thrown out. Shazia is sitting here,
I just want to add a small caveat, and that caveat is very simple.
Yeah.
I love the observations coming from Ragini Nayak today about the need for democracy, transparency, and consensus coming from a party where a bunch of political fossils from the Congress Working Committee a few weeks from now will get together to crown the greatest failure in Indian politics, Rahul Gandhi, as the next party president. Please continue. Please continue now with your attack on the
Arnab, Mr. Arnab Goswami.
I know my name. Continue.
I have
don't be sorry. It's an observation.
Congress party evolved the concept of internal democracy.
I am sure.
We nurtured
a democracy. Internal democracy between AK Antony, Motilal Vora and Oscar Fernandez.
What kind
your
of democracy. Internal
democracy
was there in the party?
Good.
And how we are trying to build a new model.
Anyway,
of
tonight we'll spare the Congress.
Under the leadership of Mr. Rahul Gandhi, the experiment is complete in NSUI and Youth Congress.
Sure.
Would see that implemented in the main party
Mr.
as well.
Goswami.
But
sure.
The point that I'm making tonight is that I'm
let's
really
open this up. It's an open debate. I'm not taking it around. Shazia, let's go back to the Aam Aadmi Party subject tonight. Shazia, to be fair.
Amongst this conspiracy, Arnab, give me 10 seconds, please.
Your 10 seconds
more.
Are endless.
Amidst this conspiracy, this name-calling, this blame game. No, I'm just finishing. Amidst all this blame game, I'm worried about the people of Delhi. If the Aam Aadmi Party cannot set its own house in order, how is it going to deliver the 70 promises
I'm pretty
it made
sure.
in its manifesto to the people of Delhi?
Yeah, only
this
Rahul Gandhi
kind
can
of
deliver Delhi now.
For which the people of Delhi voted in Aam Aadmi Party.
Only Rahul Gandhi can deliver Delhi with the active support of Sheila.
He will in the near future. Don't you worry.
Yeah, I'm sure you will. Now.
Don't you worry. He's going to deliver not just in Delhi, but nationally.
Prashant Bhushan has just said it is unfortunate it came to this. Tonight, Shazia, let's reveal everything. Nalin, I'm coming to you, but let's get the inside story out. To be fair, Shazia has spoken about it on several occasions. There was one occasion where she began revealing everything and I told Shazia, are you revealing everything because you're bitter now, because you're no longer with the party? She said no, she revealed a lot of stories. There were two debates she was in, one with Ashish Khetan, one with Pankaj Gupta in the past. Now, Shazia, I want you to respond to Professor Kamal Mitra Chinoy, who says we will not tolerate leaks, we will not tolerate dissemination. Kamal Mitra Chinoy appears to be...
I did not say we would not tolerate leaks. Arnab, that's a distortion.
What, you just
Arnab,
said it.
You are distorting. I said we don't want leaks.
These are the kind of...
The party wants leaks
sir,
that create organizational
Mr. Professor
problems.
Chinoy...
So there are enough people
Professor
misinterpreting us...
Professor
like
Chinoy,
Congress,
Professor Chinoy,
so you shouldn't join
Professor Chinoy, what a fall from grace. What a fall from grace, sir.
Unfair and untrue.
What a fall from grace for you and your party, from a party that said we have nothing to hide, to a party that now wants to create a fortress around itself, surrounded by a moat of henchmen. Now, responding to you is Shazia Elmi. Shazia.
Yes, I would like to remind Mr. Chinoy that the leak and speak that you were talking about is the standard procedure of Aam Aadmi Party and its dirty tricks department, which works pretty much as a carefully orchestrated drama. It's like a fixed match, and I have been saying it the last 3 days. One can see it coming. PAC is the most important body which takes all the decisions. It was crucial to remove Yogendra Yadav and Prashant Bhushan from there because they were the ones, and they waited until the elections, just like I did. I waited until the Lok Sabha elections, after which I raised questions, and they did the same after the Vidhan Sabha elections. So if they had to mar the chances or the electoral chances of Aam Aadmi Party, they could have done this so-called leak and speak earlier. But they did not do it. It was done by others, which is why surreptitiously
I did not accuse them of
that. Dilip Pandey's letter.
No, misinterpreted. I did not accuse
Dilip Pandey
either Yogen or Prashant of leak
and speak. So obviously it's not them. Yeah, but someone else did. And obviously who benefited from this is very obvious. And then 8 months back, a recording was made. And of course, I know for sure that all recordings are made and they actually stored on a hard disk drive to kind of keep people in check.
Recording?
But that was used and it found its way very surreptitiously. Yeah, the recording of Vibhav about Yogendra Yadav.
You're saying that Arvind Kejriwal had set up like a internal spy agency to fix Yogendra Yadav.
You know, it's like a, you know, it's, I mean, short of calling it Jassi or a secret.
No, why are you laughing? Shazia, Aarti Jairath, I must let them in, I'm coming back to you.
I've been an
Aarti Jairath and Ajay Bose are laughing. The question here is a revelation being made by a party insider that Arvind Kejriwal runs an internal CIA through which he fixes the phones of people in order to tap information to fix people inside his own party. I think this issue should be put to the test. Is Arvind Kejriwal an espionage king?
A cartoon would be a good idea.
Whose cartoon?
Internal CIA, oh lovely. Aam Aadmi is tapped Aadmi. Very good flight of information.
Okay, so is it not true that Arvind Kejriwal's assistants recorded a journalist recently into revealing that the source of the information about the troubles within the Aam Aadmi party was Yogendra Yadav? Is it not true, Ajay Bose? Aarti Jairath and Ajay Bose, either of you want to pick that up?
It is.
Yeah, I'd like to, but can you hear us?
Yeah, we can hear you loud and clear. Carry on. Why were you both laughing?
Okay. Because, you know, I wouldn't take the word of a disgruntled ex-party member that seriously, Arnab. And, you know, at the end of the day, look, whatever happened today, two people are out of the PAC. But remember, the Aam Aadmi Party still has 67 out of 70 MLAs left in Delhi and a government to run. And, you know, this two-day drama will be forgotten, like we forgot when Modi rose and ousted Advani and all the, you know, old guard of the BJP and rose to become the number one person in the BJP. Do we ever think, or do we
no,
ever
but do you remember? Sorry.
No,
sorry. Aarti, that's not.
Life carries on.
No, Aarti, what kind of defense is that? You're saying, do we remember the system by which Narendra Modi threw out
Advani?
I'm
talking practical politics.
Yeah, I am also talking practical politics, but. But what did.
But Kejriwal was never talking about practical politics. He was talking about idealistic, transformational kind of politics. Is this the kind of politics for which the people of Delhi have voted for him? I don't think so, Ms. Aarti Jairath.
How is the recording? How do you connect with me being disgruntled?
Arnab, can I come in?
Sorry,
Arnab, can I come in?
Please, you can. Ajay Bose.
Can I come in, Arnab?
Yes, Ajay Bose and Shazia.
Arnab, can I come in?
Go ahead.
The great, Arnab, please. The great Mahatma Gandhi, who spoke so many moral things. If you really look back at the freedom struggle, if you look at his struggle with Netaji Subhas Bose, please, I mean, don't try and divorce politics from intrigue.
Sorry.
Do not, please,
sorry,
there is power struggle in political parties.
This is not about intrigue.
This is a political party.
This is not
Arvind
about
Kejriwal will of, fight against people who he feels is against this thing.
No.
This is supposed to be a party with a difference.
But let me ask Kamal Mitra Chanoy.
You have among the people and how many supporters you have within the party.
Very good.
And I'm glad that all this has happened.
Very good.
Too much pretensions used to be attached with the AAP. Too much halo was that it was something special. There's nothing special about politics.
No, but I'm sorry, but then there is no support for the Aam Aadmi Party. One second.
And within the party, you have to get rid of people you feel are against acting against your interests.
My God, Ajay Bose. My God, I can't believe you are the same Ajay Bose. You are the same Ajay Bose who said at one point of time.
Mr. Goswami.
One second. Come, Nalin Kohli is coming into the debate. I remind you, Ajay Bose.
Please.
I remind you that what did Arvind Kejriwal say? When Modi was called a dictator, when Advani was made part of the Margdarshak Mandal, the Aam Aadmi Party led by Arvind Kejriwal said, Modi is a dictator, Advani and Joshi have no haisiyat in front of him. That was the time when Arvind Kejriwal used to say, we but will never be a one-person party. Today you speak against Arvind Kejriwal, you demand accountability, you ask why criminals are made into party candidates and you are thrown out overnight. Nalin Kohli is coming to the debate. Yes, Nalin Kohli. Nalin Kohli is into the debate on the broom war tonight. Nalin Kohli. Nalin Kohli, please. Nalin Kohli.
May I?
Nalin Kohli, yes. What would you say to Kamal?
Well, I have May I just make a few points? I have a few points to make. First of all is that the irony can't be missed. This is the new model of democracy. Ask me no questions and I will not sack you. And that's exactly what we are seeing here. Secondly, this question will arise whether Mr. Kejriwal has a use and throw policy, whether it was with Anna Hazare, Shazia's on the show. You've seen a whole series of people who were part of what was an idea, and genuinely that idea captivated a large part of people in Delhi, some outside Delhi too. And that's the result of why you see a full majority government, which is a sweep, 67 out of 70. There's no denying it. But what are the questions being asked of? Now, that's important. The questions being asked were on transparency and funding.
Yes.
So that this
Professor
party
Chennai.
Would live up to the ideals they have been professing.
Yeah.
And it's on that the two founding members, even more important, these are the founding members of an idea that took shape on the ground. Now, the point that arises is, what is it about? Ashutosh tweets, this is a fight between the ultra-left who wants a referendum in Kashmir and those who want welfare politics. Fascinatingly, this ultra-left view on Kashmir wasn't 2011 by Mr. Prashant Bhushan before the Aam Aadmi Party was founded.
Hypocrite.
So therefore, once you find someone inconvenient, after you've founded a party with them, you say, get lost. That's it. Another thing I want to say is that with regard to the Aam Aadmi Party, what you've said is the Arvind alone party. They are entitled. They want to run it like that. They can run it like that. But Mr. Goswami, the question can't be denied. Is Mr. Kejriwal also a political coward? If media reports are to be believed, he was in Delhi while the meeting was taking place. He didn't attend that meeting. Now, that's what the media has reported.
Kamal Mitra Chinoy.
My last point.
Kamal Mitra Chinoy.
That the media is the only institution in this country. The only institution in this country that has the right to ask questions relentlessly. That's the nature of the media across the world. But the media also has the courage to introspect when difficult questions in such certain situations are asked of it. The Aam Aadmi Party or the Arvind alone party, as you are calling it, and perhaps that's what it is becoming, they only ask questions when questions are asked by people from within them. They are intolerant to even them. They've never answered questions of anyone else.
And who is Arvind supporting today, Kamal Mitra Chinoy? Respond. Why are you quiet? Or have you been silenced by the arguments put on the other side? Who is Arvind Kejriwal supporting, Kamal Mitra Chinoy? He is supporting people who hold liquor during elections.
From the other side, I mean, Nalin knows very well that Advani and others were sidelined by the BJP. Okay, neither Yogen nor Prashant have been sidelined.
They've been kicked out.
They've been shifted to a new committee to be.
They have been kicked out of the political affairs committee. Don't
to a Lokpal. Which
this is the new model of democracy, according to the Aam Aadmi Party. I heard, I was on another show, on television, Mr. Goswami. They clearly said they democratically took a decision, wanting the world to believe that Mr. Yadav and Mr. Prashant Bhushan voted against themselves. That's a new democracy.
And
along with six others, the
also,
media channels also. The report is out.
A completely false allegation. Arnab, you should not get into this habit. Both Prashant
and Yogen said they voted.
No, I'm sorry. Don't tell me about democracy within the party. Don't tell me what I should say or not say. This is
no one second. So they are supposed to be voting against themselves.
Not a session.
That's what Arvind alone party spokesperson said on another channel.
Is this a trait of Arvind Kejriwal? Has he become extremely egotistical, arrogant, intolerant of dissent? And is this the beginning of his downfall? 1 minute, sir.
This is not the...
Oh, Mr. Goswami, perhaps he's not become... He's always been so. That is the other possibility. It's merely exposed now. That's another way of looking at it.
Shazia is coming into the debate with a question for Kamal Mitra Chinoy. Shazia.
Yes, I would like to point out to Mr. Chinoy that he keeps talking about Lokpal. Admiral Ramdas was the Lokpal, and you read his letter. If you read Prashant Bhushan's letter, which has been leaked, and I'm sure Prashant Bhushan was not behind it, it raises important questions on transparency, decentralization, funding and expenses, and also talks about the criminal candidates with serious cases against them. Those are relevant questions, and that was the rationale and raison d'etre of Aam Aadmi Party. So somebody who upholds the principles on basis of which the party was made is being asked to go. That's very relevant. Also, I would like to point out to R.P. Jairaj that you might call me. Let me finish.
Shazia, he says...
I know what is happening because I was... These are exactly the same reasons. These are the same reasons why I left the party.
Unlike you, we are close to Prashant. And yes, we've heard what he had to say.
Yeah, I'm in touch with everybody in the party besides Arvind Kejriwal and Mayank Gandhi. Kamalji, let me speak. Let me finish, sir. Sir, if you allow me to speak and finish my version. Kamalji, you've been told by Raghav Chadda on Times Now not to speak for Aam Aadmi Party because you're not the official spokesperson. So that's how open they are vis-a-vis you. I don't know, you don't have to do this to yourself.
So I would like
to tell Aarti Jairath, who can call me disgruntled, that Aarti, you lack objectivity. You can subjectively insult me. Kamalji, let me finish, sir. Okay, you speak then. But I want a minute later on, after you're done, sir.
No,
I would like to.
Yes, I do.
I belong to the BJP, but I was an Aam Aadmi Party and I was in the national executive and I was there for 3.5 years. Yes. And I will speak about it.
One minute. Okay, fine. So fine. Let's set the ground rules here. One second. Ajoyda and Aarti and also Professor Chinoy. May I make a point here?
I don't like hypocrisy. That's all.
Okay. Yadav and Prashant Bhushan.
I think we have to be hard-nosed about politics, Arna.
No. This hard-nosed about politics is a very good idea. But what is it? Is 1 second. Aarti, now listen. Aarti, please listen.
Aam Aadmi Party was never a Camelot.
And I always. Dislike,
oh my God! Please hear me.
I always dislike the pretensions of the of the Aam Aadmi Party.
Ajoyda, 1 minute. Tonight you are saying I dislike the pretensions of the Aam Aadmi Party. Well, frankly, so do I. But then, no. 1 second. Nobody told the Aam Aadmi Party to be a walking, talking political hypocrite. They were the ones who says, "Hum alag hai." हम ऑनेस्टी की बात करते हैं हम ट्रांसपेरेंट हैं नो नो आफ्टर नो 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 टू सो टुनाइट नो नो सो टुनाइट यू कांट टर्न अराउंड एंड से सॉरी 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 नलिन कोहली
प्लीज
Mr. Goswami, just a point about what Aartiji is saying, and with due respect to Aartiji,
Aartiji,
may I just make a point? With due respect to Aartiji, What I find is strange, because through and through I recall RTG and other commentators would repeatedly use the Aam Aadmi Party as an example, and they would, it used to be almost a flogging stick for the BJP and other parties.
Yes.
But today we are becoming hard-nosed about politics. So where was that skepticism about them? Where was that questioning? They were taken at face value.
How can you say
admittedly every political party? Every political party, Ajoy Bhai, one second. Every political party of the country would have problems, would have good things too. What we are seeing here is a pattern, and that pattern cannot be discounted from the inception. A use and throw pattern. Well, I mean, you've got two very good spokespersons. The way I think RTG is getting agitated, so at least the Aam Aadmi Party has sympathy. So we have to say that they have an impact.
What goes on between Arvind Kejriwal and Yogendra Yadav?
Governance comes with consistency in values. It comes with wanting to work, not just asking questions consistently, not taking answers and deciding not to work. That's what the model is. They are. What is the model? I will ask all the questions. But as the Arvind alone party, will ask all the questions. Nobody can ask questions of me.
And I also think tonight.
Secondary.
One minute. Just give me 30 seconds. Don't speak all over together. Ragini, 1 minute, please stop. Ragini, stop for a minute. I want to steer the debate. 34 minutes past nine. This is India's number one trend, the broom war. Ragini, I'm coming to you. Have patience. 1 minute. My question tonight, I actually want the supporters of the Aam Aadmi Party, who are extremely vocal, namely Aarti and Ajoyda, and also Mr. Kamal Mitra Chennoi, to just understand one thing. The people of this country, if there is the Aam Aadmi Party has any support base, it's not like people like Arvind Kejriwal's face or like Arvind Kejriwal as an individual. People think Aam Aadmi Party is a different force in Indian politics. Today, I'm asking you, is it wrong? What about the issues being raised? What are the issues being raised? Lack of transparency, lack of inner party democracy, one man centric party, compromise on candidates, liquor and cash, financial irresponsibility, political compromise. These are issues when Arvind Kejriwal went to Varanasi, to fight against Narendra Modi, he said, I represent all these issues. I'm sorry, Aarti, hear me. He said, I don't want to shout over you, Aarti. He said, I represent all these issues. I am the new force in Indian politics and I will be different. I'm sorry, but it is not about Yogendra Yadav or Prashant Bhushan, Aarti. You're not getting the point.
In the campaign. Yogendra Yadav and
I give up.
Bhushan,
I mean, are you not even going to listen?
In the Delhi campaign.
Are you not going to understand? Don't get
political leader.
But Ajoyda and Aarti, may I request you to just allow me one notch.
What is the problem? I mean, why are we giving?
I'm putting this question to you, the viewers. If you are watching tonight, and I will just, I don't want to speak over it, but I hope I can be heard tonight. I'm just saying one thing, Ajoyda, just listen to me. Ajoyda, listen to me. And I'm asking.
You know, 2 years later, they can.
Okay, 1 second, Ajoyda.
Kamal.
No, 1 second. One at a time, please.
What is otherwise?
Ajoyda, 1 minute. What are you saying, Kamal Mitra Chennoi here? Are you saying the issues raised are irrelevant?
I am certainly not saying that.
Then
but
what
I'm
are you saying?
That don't misinterpret the issues.
What is there to interpret or misinterpret? These are about ethical principles.
What?
You can say today we are hard-nosed politicians. No. You are saying today the argument being used. The argument.
Not do that.
Sir,
now
please.
The question is.
Sir, the argument being used is, please, Kamal Mitra Chennoi, remember, be careful. Tomorrow you will be a casualty
please
also. If you continue to be outspoken, you will also be thrown out. Be careful. Be very careful
tell
in that party.
Other party
watch your step. I mean, I'm not giving.
Please tell me.
What am I? I'm just
I
saying.
I don't even know if your channel has an internal Lokpal.
Sir, 1 second. We have internal guidelines, but we don't have halos around our heads and we are not fighting elections. My question is principally very simple tonight.
But we have an admiral as a Lokpal.
Yeah. But the admiral also
admiral,
does not agree with your general. You have a field marshal who is the last person.
Sunk in the water.
Now, you see, 1 second. Right. So we are tonight with the argument being made here. And I'm coming to you, Ragini, tonight.
Cynical.
1 second. The argument being put here. Sir, I hear you. The argument. argument. The argument being put tonight is simple, and I think everyone who's seeing the AAP and their spokespersons on NewsHour is realizing the argument is this. The AAP is saying tonight, don't complain too much. We have become practical, hard-nosed politicians. We fight among each other. The tough guy wins. The others weren't tough.
That's a caricature.
Bad luck. Arvind is the tough guy. The others will be thrown out. So this, therefore, if this is the argument, then I'm asking tonight, what's the difference? You are like the BSP. Mayawati is the tough leader. You are like Jayalalitha. She's the tough leader. Can anyone speak against Jayalalitha? No. Tomorrow, you will say that before Arvind Kejriwal, you'll have to do an Ashtanga Pranam. So that you can show how loyal you are to Arvind Kejriwal, and the level of intolerance of Arvind Kejriwal is a matter of political legend. But is this a good way to run a party? With a question which will be asked. Shazia is coming back to the debate, but before that, Ragini.
Tell me, which of these
Ragini is coming back now, please.
Does not
and
have a major leader.
If you have changed, Ragini, please now. Arti, I'm asking Ragini to come in.
Who are you?
Please allow me, Mr. Chinoy. I've been hearing you patiently. Although you don't have any answers, I've been hearing you. You see, Arnab, it would only have been fair on your part if you would also have taken a dig at MAP or the Modi alone party, a leader who has sidelined all the veterans in his party and running BJP like a private enterprise.
RAP and MAP. Interesting.
Come back to the point. I want to remind you that last year on 5th June, Manish Sisodia also
thank
Ragini
ji for that word. Three words.
Of Yogendra Yadav.
One second.
One minute. That letter was also leaked. But no national executive was called to take care of the matter. The PAC wasn't called. We don't even know what happened to what kind of disciplinary action was taken against Mr. Manish Sisodia. So is it that within the framework of the Aam Aadmi Party, there are some caste leaders and there are some AAP leaders?
Yogendra
so the VVIP
Yadav
culture, which the Aam Aadmi Party
Bhushan
was fighting and proclaiming that they are against the VVIP culture, is a part and parcel
and
of Aam Aadmi Party. Because
so
those
not
who
like
are
your
close
party.
To Mr. Kejriwal
like
are actually
party.
Very caste,
your party
are VVIP. And those who are not are given
show.
A secondary status within
one
the party.
Often does not
and
show.
Secondly, the Aam Aadmi Party has been propagating the idea that they believe in decentralization of power, which they're going to bring about in Delhi through Swaraj Bill, through Mohalla
yes.
committees,
yes.
through a distribution of MLA yes. funds only after consultation with the people. But if Mr. Kejriwal cannot initiate decentralization of power in his own
party,
if the entire party power of the Aam Aadmi Party is vested with Mr. Kejriwal, I don't know how on earth is he going to deliver on this promise. You know, I think that the ball was in Mr. Kejriwal's court. He had a big opportunity to prove that the idealistic transformational politics that he wanted to bring about, the promise of idealistic politics
Interesting twist. 41 minutes past 9. 41 minutes past 9.
Today,
so don't give us.
I think the people of Delhi today think that they have been hoodwinked by Mr. Kejriwal.
Of course,
the entire image makeover process, the rebranding of Mr. Kejriwal, which was done prior to Delhi elections, in which he was shown as a Democrat.
Kamal Mitra, Chinoy, Ragini, don't go non-stop. Don't speak non-stop. 1 minute. Kamal Mitra, Chinoy, at least let there be some democracy, if not within the Aam Aadmi Party. Sorry, Arvind alone party, at least on the NewsHour. My only limited point tonight is this. Look at your party before and after. One second.
Mr. Goswami.
One second. Are my God, tonight, Professor, you are a professor at JNU. You are a professor at JNU. Sir, 1 minute. Sir, Professor, listen, please. I'm not your student. Professor, listen. Professor, listen to me. Ragini, 1 minute. Professor, listen to me. Look at the terrible irony tonight. Your arguments have slowly moved away. You realize that your own logic is beginning to give way. And at this point in the debate, 42 minutes past 9, you use the emergency to justify your actions. You do this despite being a professor at JNU, which fought the emergency. I am horrified, Professor, with utmost respect.
What happened, Arnab?
I am horrified.
Your phone not working.
I'm horrified. Second point is, in your website, I'll just give you one example.
Yeah,
in your
I'm
website,
horrified.
In
that
your website,
you
sir, please listen to me.
And make a
sir,
putting professor, out of things
professor,
which don't happen.
Professor Chennai, in your website, you say,
before unlike you, Arnab, sir, I was thrown out of this campus for 3 months.
Sir, a dash of nostalgia for you.
My opposition to the emergency.
A dash of
the fact that I called a strike.
A dash of
don't try those ones on me.
I don't try anyone, sir.
One second. You have much less political experience.
Sir,
so don't give me these lessons,
sir. I have
ABC of politics.
Sir,
that's not how politics works.
Sir, sure.
Except perhaps in a channel.
Sure, Professor. Calm down,
Mr. Goswami. Beyond the ABC of politics, may I have a word also?
I just want to tell you, Professor.
And why don't you ask? Why don't you ask
Yogin
and Prashant if they had a right to vote and whether they exercised it or not?
Sir, you know something. Oscar Fernandez.
You have to go by
sir,
word.
Sir, can I please,
them.
Can I say something or you're going nonstop?
You forget.
1 minute,
you
sir.
Them.
1 minute. Let me tell you about
Mr.
the democracy.
Goswami,
let me tell you about the democracy of the Congress Party.
Horse.
1 minute. 1 minute, Professor. What
point.
Is going on? What has
your
happened? You were a nice person business. Before you joined the Aam Aadmi Party. And look, and you don't let me speak now. Please listen to me, Professor. You know, in the Congress also there is
I
democracy.
Think I'm a nicer person.
In the Congress also
yes,
there is democracy. Sir, in the Congress also, please listen to me. In the Congress also there is democracy.
Please
and in the Congress, the democracy is represented by Ahmed Patel, Oscar Fernandez, Makhanlal, Fotedar, R.K. Dhawan, and all other such psychophants of the Gandhi family.
A Congress, a party which got zero in Delhi, zero.
Well,
Nalin Kohli coming into the debate because I don't think Professor is
making a point.
Nalin Kohli.
He was removed from the presidentship of the party immediately.
May I?
Nalin Kohli.
Ragini ji, my worry is once Ragini ji starts, then no one else can have a word. So perhaps, Mr. Goswami, may I have an uninterrupted chance of saying something?
Mr. Arnab Goswami?
No, 1 second, please. Yogendra Yadav in a snide
okay,
reference to Arvind Kejriwal, in a snide reference
Chennai,
to Arvind Kejriwal, and in a
so
veiled threat.
No, we know there's
in
a
veiled threat.
There,
Yogendra Yadav has just said breaking
inception.
News. Yogendra Yadav has just said
so,
the foundation of a party is at the
Mr.
bottom,
Goswami,
not at the top. Yes, please, Nalin Kohli.
Okay, my point is. The Aam Aadmi Party, essentially, if you look at its nature, has almost been behaving like a media institution. And I said this earlier, they constantly ask questions. They don't like questions being asked on them. Now, the point here is, within the media, and I was speaking, referring to what Aarti was just saying a short while ago, perhaps there may be a few people, commentators, who may not like the BJP. So they were taken in by a concept called the Aam Aadmi Party. Conceptually, it was very attractive. There's no doubt. Now, the point is, as it is opening out there, that this is, as you're calling it, an Arvind alone party, that becomes unattractive. So you say, no, let's compare them with the others. They are unique because there's no performance behind the Aam Aadmi Party. Behind every political party, there's a whole period of struggle. There's a whole journey and they have to stand up based on their performance or they have to bite the dust because they haven't performed. Here, there is growth based on talk. And before they can even perform, they are already splitting. The second point is what Ragini said about map. And she said it called it the
How's
Modi
it
alone
splitting?
Party. Let's go to the word map.
How's it splitting?
Certainly,
no
if you look at the map of India, and I can understand why you are petrified, Ragini ji. In the map of India, the Congress is at the fringes. If you continue like this,
so
good wishes to you. You may have to learn swimming. Because the only thing beyond the fringes is the deep sea.
Two electoral victories, Mr. Nalin Kohli. Can cleanse all your misdemeanors and all your wrongdoings.
No, listen, Nalin,
so
I think
let me just remind you, it's actually seven. No, ma'am, it's actually seven just in humility. I just thought, let's get the count correct. Let's get the count correct. And as many victories as you're putting on us, those are the wonderful performance of your leadership. So if you want to celebrate the success of your leadership, you are entitled to.
In fact,
we would like you to celebrate that.
5 minutes on this debate, I'm going back to Shazia Elmi. 5 minutes on this debate. 5 minutes on this debate. I did promise tonight. 5 minutes on this debate. 5 minutes on this debate. And I did promise tonight that I would give Shazia an opportunity. Kamal Mitra Chennai, take a deep breath. Relax. Please hear someone. And if you want to speak up so much for the Aam Aadmi Party, may I remind you, sir, may I remind you that there was a person called Yogendra Yadav. I just will say something. Please share. There was a person called Yogendra Yadav. Yogendra Yadav was so angry with Times Now. 1 minute, sir, relax. So 1 minute, last December, when two stories had been done critical of the Aam Aadmi Party, Yogendra Yadav said, how we will not tolerate this point of view. He called and he said, you can't do stories like this which are critical of the Aam Aadmi Party. And Yogendra Yadav ensured that for 1 month and more, there was not a single spokesman of Aam Aadmi Party coming on this channel called Times Now. Today, Yogendra Yadav, who must be bruising himself, will realize what happens when things get so arrogant. So, Kamal Mitra Chinoy, watch your step. You never know when the ice cracks. And the ice right now of the Aam Aadmi Party under your professorial feet is very thin. The ice under your feet is very thin, sir.
Of Times Now. You again might have said this, but I was the first Aam Aadmi Party to come after.
Okay,
that.
That's not now. You're now professor. You will listen a few things. I now at this stage 5 minutes on the debate. I invite Shazia Ilmi to tell Professor. I invite Shazia Ilmi to tell Professor Kamal Mitra Chinoy. I invite Shazia Ilmi to tell Kamal Mitra Chinoy the inside stories of what is the rot within the Aam Aadmi Party.
Have Yogin
Professor Chinoy, can you?
In a position of
Professor, what's wrong here?
Okay, they won't meet.
Professor, listen.
But there are other organizations.
Becoming a cacophony of thoughts.
And we will create them. So please do not attack us on false premises and false grounds. I can understand that we do not conform to your idea of what a political party may be. I don't know what kind of conforming that would be anyway, what kind of party. We do not conform to Shazia's party because Shazia is still in a transition from
I want
to BJP.
Allow me to speak.
And I don't know if a transition will stop
sir.
There.
I don't understand. You see, Mr. Allow Chinoy.
Me to speak, I would request Professor Chinoy to listen tonight.
Can you allow me to speak, Arnab?
This is horrifying. Shazia, please. Shazia is saying something, and at this stage of the debate, Shazia is going to reveal the inside story of the
Aam. You say that I should listen, and you provoke me with Arvind alone party. Suppose I say Arnab alone party.
You have to allow
Arnab alone channel.
What you're saying, Professor Chinoy.
Mr. Goswami, this is really funny. Somebody just SMS'd and said this is the way the Aam Aadmi Party is going. It's become an Arvind alone party. But you know, it might well become the Arvind Akela party also.
What do you mean Arvind alone? Did Arvind alone win Delhi?
I would like to.
As Arvind said.
So why can't you have plenty of a sense of humor? Relax.
Arvind alone.
All right. So I have a sense of humor, Professor.
Those who helped Mr. Chinoy, that's fascinating. Those who helped Mr. Arvind Kejriwal win Delhi are being sacked. So I mean, that's really funny.
Sorry, I'm very scared of Arvind Kejriwal. We should talk like this, right?
He will be
watching. Well, Arvind Kejriwal, if you're watching, if you are watching Arvind Kejriwal, this is what people are saying about your party. It's the Arvind alone party. Shazia, please, I'm only inviting Shazia. Let only Shazia speak, please. Yes, Shazia.
Please do not allow Professor Chinoy to filibuster this debate the way he is.
Go ahead, Shazia, go ahead.
Also including
please don't allow him. You have to kill his mic. Let me say one thing.
Our personality.
Yeah, Shazia, go ahead.
One individual.
Shazia, go ahead.
Professor Chinoy, it's very unbecoming of you to be filibustering through this debate and not allow others to come in. It is quite shameful the way you're conducting yourself, Professor Chinoy. I had a lot of respect for you until now. It's really disgusting how you're filibustering and hyperventilating on this debate, not allowing anyone else to speak. I would like to tell you and the other spokesperson, Aarti Jairath and Ajoy Bose, that I, unlike three of you, worked hard, gave up my job, was there for 3.5 years for political transformation.
Aarti, let her.
No,
let me finish. And I have every right to join the BJP or Congress, whichever party I want to join. Let me finish what I want to say.
Let me finish what I want to say.
You have to allow me to speak.
You are independent. You would have had some credibility.
You can come in.
No, no, I'm letting Shazia speak.
But by joining BJP, you've destroyed all credibility.
Let me allow me to speak. I want to finish.
You've destroyed all credibility. By joining BJP,
I think
if you were
I think AAP's credibility is non-existent. I have every right to choose whichever party I want to choose. And I have, and you have not, so you have a pathological hatred. Aarti Jairath, you have a pathological hatred for BJP, which is why you lack objectivity. You lack objectivity. You compromise as a journalist. You compromise as a journalist. You don't look at facts. You're biased, which is the worst thing a journalist can be or an observer. You're biased. What about your language? You call me disgruntled, but you're biased. It is far more. You're biased. You are biased. But you're the one who attacked me.
You can be bitter.
You can be bitter.
That's all right.
You did nothing for Aam Aadmi Party. You have a pathological hatred for BJP.
The party that gave you the prominence you got today. I'm sorry, Shazia.
Well, what about you, Aarti Jairath? You lack objectivity, which is the worst thing a journalist can be. You have a pathological hatred for a party.
I'm just a journalist.
Yes.
I don't know.
Yes, that's
no
what you are.
Yeah,
and I'm a political activist.
Sorry, but Aarti, can you... Aarti and Aarti and Shazia, can you...
I'm proud of my choice.
Can I stop the personal barbs now, please? Can I go back to the subject? And the question tonight is this. No, 1 second. Aarti, enough, please. 1 second. Aarti and Shazia, no personal sparring. The question, no personal sparring.
I'm replying to that.
The question tonight is this, and I'm repeating the question to Shazia Elmi. Aarti, please don't. Aarti, please don't. 4 minutes on the debate. 4 minutes on the debate. I am asking Shazia once again, and Aarti, let's not get distracted. Viewers, I want you to vote on whether, using the hashtag broom war, which is trending on Twitter right now, I want you to tell us whether you think the AAP will be able to come out of this big split down the middle. Now, I would like to invite Shazia and Shazia alone to speak, because she raised certain issues of the inner workings of the Aam Aadmi Party. Now, whether you agree with her or not, these stories which she reveals are interesting. Shazia, tell us on these critical issues, one or two of these, so that there can be open challenge from the other side if they disagree with you. Lack of transparency, inner party democracy, one-man-centric party. Compromise on candidates. Lack of financial probity. These are five allegations that even Yadav and Prashant Bhushan have put, at least Prashant Bhushan has put. Now, I want you to tell Professor Chennoy, as well as Ajay Bose and Aarti Jairath, who are defending the Aam Aadmi Party, a little bit in a couple of minutes, if you want to share any specific facts. If they disagree with you, they will challenge you. Here are your 2 minutes. Start now. Shazia, let us speak.
No, sir,
let her speak. Before she speaks, you take off.
Exactly.
I am not a defector, so I don't need lessons from Shazia.
She has a right to speak and her perspective, give her perspective.
Uncorroborated evidence is not evidence.
Well, okay, fine. Now you made the caveat, listen to her. Yeah.
But isn't this evidence? Isn't this sting operation an evidence? Isn't the unceremonial ouster of Yogendra Yadav and Prashant Bhushan an evidence? Isn't the letter by the Lokpal, who is Admiral Ramdas, an evidence? How much evidence do you seek? What more evidence do you want? The candidature of Kartar Singh Tawar, Sahiram, and all these gundas, is that not evidence?
Evidence of the Lokpal,
two crores of rupees and Khokha companies, is that not evidence?
Joining this
what more is evidence? Is this evidence? You might have a problem with BJP. That's another point, and we will debate that. We will debate that. Right now, we're discussing.
It's a clean party,
we will discuss.
Unlike yours.
But you know what the Lokpal is?
Your party has never had a Lokpal.
You're not up to speed, sir.
And
you're not letting
and you
me
should
speak.
Know that because you were in
yeah,
the
but
party.
What about it? What is the Lokpal saying? The Lokpal is calling you a
but you
club.
Cannot say that we don't
the
have internal mechanisms
club.
For
I will say it. As a citizen
rules,
of this country, I will say whatever I want
promises.
To say and choose whichever party I want to say. And I want to say that Aam Aadmi Party is like any other party. It has compromised its basic principles. Arvind Kejriwal has used the whole anti-corruption movement, betrayed the trust of people for his own
sure
self-aggrandizement. And some people have a pathological hatred for BJP, which is why they are propping up Arvind Kejriwal. But they all know the truth about Arvind Kejriwal.
To Ghaziabad.
Yes.
So I mean, don't try with me. We have seen
yes,
you
exactly.
Enough.
Yes, whoever got a ticket.
Yes,
whoever exactly. Whoever got a ticket. Oh, you have
Admiral
supported me.
Ramdas says
I was a founder member of Aam Aadmi Party. I was a founder member of Aam Aadmi Party, sir.
Admiral Ramdas
I contested
Arjipuram
the first ever election. And but all of you are making fun of Aam Aadmi Party.
MLAs
don't tell me about Aam Aadmi Party,
sir. Are going to rotate in the ministries. So don't. I am in Aam Aadmi Party. You're a has-been.
Professor Chinoy, you should have the decency to hear the other person out.
And I can see
Professor Chinoy, you have to look at facts.
You
have to have objectivity. I left Aam Aadmi Party 8 months back, sir. And I've been saying this ever since. And I waited for Lok Sabha elections to happen. And these are exactly the same reasons that Yogendra Yadav and Prashant Bhushan are saying. Just because you hate BJP, you can't condone everything AAP does. Even if it's indefensible. Which indeed it is.
What I said, Yogendra Yadav and Prashant Bhushan.
No, you said so much that nobody could understand what you were saying.
Before all this happened. And they remain my friends. I'm saying this for the record. And
uncorroborated evidence, sir. This is uncorroborated evidence.
As honorable a position
this is your
as
word
possible.
Against mine, sir.
Okay.
It's uncorroborated evidence,
and
sir,
if
Mr. Chinoy. It's uncorroborated evidence. It's
publicly,
just your word against mine, sir.
We will ask.
It's
for
your
that
word
also
against mine.
All right. All right. I think this has gone on for too long. The question is very simply this, and I'm putting this to vote tonight. Nalin Kohli wants to add in a word, I will let him. The fact is, tonight, the Aam Aadmi Party has been split around the middle. Critically for the AAP, the questions are of honesty, transparency, inner party democracy, and financial probity. 1 minute, sir. 1 minute, sir. Don't show such intolerance. And if you want to tell me that anybody watching the News Hour tonight will accept this view, and I reject this view put by Arti and Ajay Bose, that this is hard-nosed politics. If this is hard-nosed politics, and by the way, the most laughable assertion today, Ajay Bose and Aarti Jairath. It is laughable to compare the power lust of the Aam Aadmi Party. It is laughable to compare Arvind Kejriwal with Mahatma Gandhi and Yogendra Yadav with Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Please, for God's sake, don't do that. That is taking it too far. Now, Nalin Kohli wants to say something.
Yeah.
Nalin Kohli.
You are making it into some...
No, I just wanted to make a point. I just wanted to... Ajoy, please, let me finish my point. Then please add what you want to. Let me finish my point, Ajoy. Ajoy, come on. Let me finish my point. Professor Chinoy said something fascinating. He speaks about a Lokpal, which is defunct in the party. This is a party that does not that has an institution that's defunct. Having a defunct institution is worse than not having a... Aartiji, why you? Let me finish my point. Then please say what you
How
have to.
How do you know that?
Second
that
is, they profess an internal democracy.
Because
it's worse to profess
Ramdas,
internal democracy and not have it. Why have this pretense?
Will be in the ministry.
It simply means the Aam Aadmi Party is a smokescreen for personal ambition. That's all it is. You profess all false things. You say we have a Lokpal. You say we have internal democracy. You say we have transparency. But hide all of that because there's personal ambition. Say it is personal ambition. Go ahead, do it. RTG, why you are speaking on behalf of the Aam Aadmi Party? I mean, I'm talking to you as a commentator. You want to be seen as a spokesperson? I have no problem. But I then have the courage to go and join them. Why take the role of a spokesperson and disturb me when I'm addressing it straight to the Aam Aadmi Party? When I address you, you address me back. But if I'm addressing the Aam Aadmi Party and you're making a point on it, I will be forced to believe that you want to speak on their behalf. You're free to, if you want to, join them if you want to. But why are you interrupting me? I'm making a point to the Aam Aadmi Party, that's all.
Why don't you critique Aam Aadmi Party on behalf of the electorate of Delhi, to whom you are responsible?
But AAP is not important beyond that, frankly. At the moment, AAP has no national.
Yes, okay, okay. From 1951, we've lost more elections. We've lost more elections than any frontline political party. And obviously, we've learned. Obviously, our leadership has performed in different states. We haven't got this on a platter. We worked ourselves and we are the custodians of people's faith to deliver to them. And we will be held responsible. But we are not here making tall promises and not working at all.
Well, one thing is clear, gentlemen. This AAP is not the AAP it used to be. One second, this AAP is not the AAP it used to be. In fact, you wouldn't recognize this AAP from the AAP of 2 years back. And by the way, the Aam Aadmi Party used to tell the BJP, don't become arrogant because you got 282
people are very upset.
Today, a lot of people would say to Professor Kamal Mitra Chinoy, don't become arrogant because you got 67 seats in the Delhi Assembly.
Since we will not earn the respect in the next election.
The real fight is about personal ambitions. The real fight is, the real tussle is about the seat of power. The Aam Aadmi Party faced its worst defeat in the Lok Sabha elections because of this perception that they are overtly ambitious. When this party emerged and evolved on the account of being a party which is only going to work for the welfare of the people, the party has no lust for power. The entire foundation provides as boomerang. And it has got topsy-turvy. And once again, the similar kind of mistake is being made. The people of Delhi have forgiven,
in December 2013. One second now, I have listened to this. Please, Professor. Professor, it's okay.
Voted for Prashant.
Professor Chennai, Professor Chennai, you are so senior to me, which is why all these personal comments you make on me, Professor, all your personal comments for me, because I respect you as a person, you're very senior, is like water off a duck's back, and in this case, I am the duck. Now, the simple question is this, please, sir. Please remember one thing. Just in December 2013, 1 minute, in December 2013, Professor, in your class, do you let students speak sometimes? I'm not even your student. Now, 1 second, Professor. The point is, in December 2013, there was a person called Rahul Gandhi. He got thrashed in an election. He came out and people asked him, and his mother was coaching him by the side what to say and telling him for how long he's allowed to be there before he goes back home. He said, I'm going to change the Congress party. We're going to learn from the Aam Aadmi Party. Today, I have just one thing to say. He doesn't have to learn from the Aam Aadmi Party, because the Aam Aadmi Party has learned everything from the Congress party instead. You see, you have your political affairs council, they have their CWC. You have your stooges, they have their stooges. You have your henchmen, they have their henchmen. We wait for Rahul Gandhi's return. Maybe Rahul Gandhi and Arvind Kejriwal can share notes on how parties should be run. Thank you for watching debate number one on the News Hour tonight. Thank you.